Alright, so in this video we are going to talk about an automatic way for finding a good learning rate. As we mentioned in the previous video, the learning rate is one of the most important knobs or hyperparameters that we have to tune. If we have a learning rate that is too large, we may jump around erratically on the loss surface. If we have a learning rate that is too small, our learning may even get stuck. So ideally we want to find a good learning rate. How do we find a good learning rate? We mentioned previously one way is to start with a learning rate that is slightly too large, where we jump around erratically, and then lower the learning rate until it is too small. And our good learning rate would be something in between. Yeah, and luckily the way we set up our Lightning module earlier, it's pretty easy to change the learning rate so that we can run some experiments. However, running these experiments manually might be tedious, so there is also an automatic learning rate finding algorithm that Lightning implements. So what you can see here is a plot of the losses on the y-axis against different learning rate values here on the x-axis. And the red dot here symbolizes the learning rate that the automatic learning rate finding algorithm found. So if we look at this loss plot, the red point here corresponds to the point that has the steepest downward slope. And as a side note, this algorithm rather picks a value that is slightly too small rather than too big. And that is because if we have a value that is slightly too small, the network will still learn, although it will learn a little bit more slowly. On the other hand, if we had a value that is too big, what can happen is that the loss will explode and the network won't learn at all. So rather, to be on the safe side, it's better to pick a value that is slightly too small. So how can we use this automatic learning rate finding algorithm in Lightning? So there is an AutoLR find setting in the trainer that we can set to true. And then if we use this setting, we can say trainer.tune to automatically find the learning rate. And this should be rather quick because it's only using a smaller data subset for a few number of steps. And then we can visualize the learning rate that it found using the plot method here. And here you can see the result on a real-world data set. You notice that it is not such a nice plot as we have seen earlier because, yeah, real-world data set can be a little bit noisy sometimes. So in fact, this plot here suggests that a value more on the left-hand side might be better because the loss is way lower here on the left-hand side. I actually ran a few experiments and picked one of the small values here on the left-hand side, but I found that the network was not learning at all because it got stuck. So in fact, the automatic learning rate finder here wasn't too bad. So on the left-hand side here, we can see the training and validation set loss. And on the right-hand side, we can see the validation set and the training set accuracies. Of course, we can see that the loss values or the loss plots here are pretty noisy. So maybe the learning rate is slightly too large. However, I should note it's also kind of due to the architecture we are using, the optimization algorithm, and the data set. Because later we will make some other tweaks to this method, and we will see that other methods also help us smoothen out the learning rate. Overall, we can observe that the network is indeed learning. So actually our learning rate that the algorithm found is not that bad. So in the next video, we will have a coding example of how we can use this learning rate finder.